KATS is Kids Action Through Science, and it's a pilot initiative of the Global Challenges Research Fund Water Security Hub, led by Newcastle University. We sent teams of experts to teach at a local school, and they talked about climate change and the Sustainable Development Goals. We aim to make this a global project and encourage climate activism around the world. The experts took in VR headsets.
You will see the elephant. Do you see the elephant?
Yeah.
Drones for climate impact monitoring. And they trialled other state-of-the-art equipment, like air quality testing kits.
Like, I'm guessing green's good, red's bad, and amber's okay.
And they took in water mobile testing suitcase labs that researchers use in developing nations.
Let's measure the pH to the probe.
We want them to embrace climate change solutions and understand, through the Sustainable Development Goals, the interconnectedness of our world.
The idea of this is our web, and we're all connected to people across the whole world. So hopefully we can look at some of those webs of connection and what we can do to combat climate change a little bit and to make the world a bit of a better place to live in.
We all connect together, and we all live on the planet, so we all need to do something about it because there's no planet B, is there?
What we have here is an air pollution sensor, okay? So this sort of connects with the phone, right? It's cool, isn't it?
Fantastic. And then you have to start a session.
We are all learning together.
Yeah.
The idea is to make the children realize their potential as citizen scientists and climate activists.
And we'll share some thoughts on how you could become an activist, and you know how you can raise your voice.
Having Newcastle University come in and working with our children on a Friday afternoon for 6 weeks has been a real joy. Watching the different academics come in and talk about their passions.
That here is the thermal camera, like you see that lens, that reflective lens.
How we can test water using a drone.
One of them collects thermal images, so you will see yourself in different colors and you can see like a relative temperature.
So my face is 20 degrees.
And seeing the excitement on the kids' faces, the project has really shown us that getting kids creative by taking climate action, that's how we can drive change.
Now the fun part is that you're going to draw your own superhero.
Choose whether you want to make your design and make your own reusable mask or make your own SDG bracelets.
That's 14, so that's life below water.
Life below water, amazing. And your green one?
That's climate action.
The superpowers are she can see everyone who litters.
What about gender equality?
I think my favourite lesson was possibly the fast fashion lesson, because I really like to shop.
A fashion fixer, superhero, mends their own clothes, donates clothing that is no longer needed, and gets creative with reusing fabric. But what we're going to learn about today is fast fashion, if anybody's heard of fast fashion, and eco-fashion, and we'll see how many litres it takes to make one cotton t-shirt, and it's absolutely mind-blowing.
It was 2,500 litres just for one cotton t-shirt.
For one t-shirt.
I think my favourite session out of all of them was definitely the soil one.
Has anyone in the room seen Britain's Got Talent? Today we're going to do Soil's Got Talent, and we're looking for the best soil.
Three, two, one.
You're all going to become climate heroes, and you're actually going to do something that helps draw carbon out of the atmosphere, that you're going to contribute positively to reducing climate change today in your garden.
For your carbon capture garden, you need a source of carbon, which you're going to get from the atmosphere through the CO2, and you need a source of calcium, and there's calcium in the volcanic rock dust.
The dust that we're putting on here makes the ground really fertile, so then loads of farmers want to live near volcanoes so they can grow bumper crops.
Excellent.
I chatted to my mum and my dad, and we talked about maybe trying to plant a carbon neutral garden in our back garden, so we've bought the volcanic rock dust, and we're actually going to create it over the holiday.
How could you become activists? You can become citizen scientists.
I think I've learned a lot. I've learned about air pollution, how to test soil quality, and also how to tell more people about climate change.
We communicate through stories.
And with stories, we can actually share personal situations of how climate change is affecting us.
Can you hear me again?
What inspired you to make Blue Planet?
We had the opportunity of speaking to the executive producer of Blue Planet 2 about storytelling and climate activism.
Storytelling has a real part to play in securing us a better future and a better future for our planet. Stories help people care. They can help people connect on an emotional level. And once we care, we're then much more likely to do something about it.
Communicate a message. Communicate it with passion and intensity. People would listen to you.
And we used VR headsets as a tool to spark their imaginations for storytelling.
I'm in the sky!
You need to listen to us and you need to think about what we're saying.
Just because we're young doesn't mean our voice shouldn't be heard.
You need to act now, not in 4 months, not in a year, but now.